Hello.
Hey, Christian Prince, how are you, my friend?
I'm fine.
Long time no see. You remember? Maybe you remember me, Rob Christian from Paul
Okay. Yeah. How are you, Rob? How are
Talk.
you? Good to have you. Yes, I remember you for sure.
Good to see you, my friend. I've been offline for a long time, but it's always a pleasure to talk to you,
Thank you.
my
Same
brother.
here.
You were mentioning the red penalties, right? That Muhammad stole.
Yeah. Did you find it? Did you know where it is? Anything? Any news?
I think some Jew he stole it, man. I'm not sure.
We have to accuse the Jews. No, it cannot be the Jews because the Muslims are the ones who are accusing the Prophet of stealing it.
That's always the Jews. Did you know that,
Yeah,
my
but
brother?
in this case they cannot do that because the Muslims are accusing the Prophet. It's not like an out or like it's an inside job, you know?
That inside job. Yeah, that
Yeah,
must be the case.
like 9/11.
You know, CP, about the story of Jacob, it's really very interesting. You know, Muslims love to use the verse from Deuteronomy 18:18, right, to show us that, hey, this is Muhammad that is mentioning here in this Deuteronomy verse, right? But they forget one thing, that when it says there will be a prophet from among you, fellow Israelites. Now, you mentioned something really important when you talk about Israel. Who is Israel? It's Jacob, right? When we go to the Bible, we know who is Israel. It's Jacob. But of course, the Muslims, the Abdus, they don't know who Israel is. So every Christian needs to ask this question first: who is Israel, and what does it mean to be a fellow Israelite? So when you explain to them that Jacob is Israel, then how is it possible that Muhammad is a brother of Jacob? That's a problem, right?
Well, first of all, why the Muslim even looking for Muhammad in the Torah when the Quran said that the one who mentioned his name is Isa, and he called him even Ahmad. He did not even call him Muhammad. You see,
Yes, yes.
the Muslims always like you know there's a short of intellect. If we go in the Quran, you will see that the one who will mention the name of what is called the Prophet of Islam is Isa, and therefore that will not be in the Old Testament. It says here, وَإِذْ قَالَ عِيسَى ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ that there is a prophet after me will come. His name is Ahmad, not Muhammad. And this is in
Yes.
chapter 61, verse number 6. So if the name of Muhammad is coming in the Old Testament, that means the one who making a lie here is Allah, for this is the wrong statement, the wrong location.
But brother, it's Muhammadim,
Yeah, but
not
in the same time, why Muhammad
Ahmed.
in the time in his time did not say to them, okay, my name is there, Muhammadim.
Muhammadim, huh?
You see, there's many things about the Muslims. When Christians they debate with Muslims, they forgot because they don't have really the knowledge. Like when a Muslim, as
Yes.
an example, say to you, that's the name of Muhammad in the Bible. Shouldn't you ask him why Muhammad never say so? And he
Yes.
why he don't quote why he don't quote any of those verses the Muslims they are quoting for us today? Why he didn't quote from John or Luke or from the Old Testament? Why Muhammad never say this is the verse speaking about me? And when the Muslims accuse, as example, Paul, they call him
Yeah.
names. Shouldn't Muhammad be the first to know about Paul if he's a bad person? Why Muhammad never say the bad word about Paul? Actually, Islamic books, all of it, speaking about Paul as a messenger of Allah. So
Exactly.
what the Muslims today are suffering from, Muslims, they are disconnected with their own cult. They don't even know their cult, but yet they claim to know your own belief. They want to teach you what your Bible mean, but they cannot even explain to us one verse in the Quran.
Yeah, but the thing is, to be honest, Christian Prince, those Muslims, the Muslims that they try to show you or show me or any Christian, hey, this is the verse that is talking about Muhammad, those people are not smart. If I was a truly smart and really genius Muslim, you know what I should answer to a Christian?
Please,
You Christians
hold on.
changed.
Did you say if I am a smart or genius Muslim? I mean, how you can find that? Are you dreaming or
I think
something?
if you are a Muslim, Christian Prince, I think you would have been a very smart Muslim.
Are you high or something?
No, you know why? You know what I'm trying to say?
I know.
I would say, hey, you Christians and Jews, you changed your Bible and you removed the name of Ahmed.
But here, but you see here that the Muslims, they have problem actually. Is the name of Muhammad Muhammad or Ahmed? Because if this is a name, the name should not be changed. If it's a title, then it's a title. And this proves my point that Muhammad is not the name of this guy. This guy, he claimed to be God. He called himself Muhammad. What Muhammad? If we ask any Muslim what Muhammad means, he will say the praised one. If yes. Muhammad is the praised one, so who is Allah?
Allah is the praised, it's the sold idol, right?
He is the idol. No, he is the praised too.
So that's, aren't you then a mushrik, CP? If you call Muhammad the anointed one, that's shirk.
Shirk, the shahada is shirk, you know, they associate the name of their God with the name of a man.
Yes.
Even Allah himself is a mushrik, because Allah, he wrote the name of Muhammad in his chair. Imagine, guys, Allah, he made a piece of furniture. And now Allah, he look at this chair, like, what is missing there? What is missing there? What? He sit in it, he flip it, he's not comfortable, something really missing there. And bingo, he got it. It is the name of Muhammad. So Allah, he decide to write in his chair that there is no God but Allah and there is no messenger but Muhammad. And then Allah, he felt so comfortable and now his chair is so beautiful after he wrote the name of Muhammad. Have you ever heard of a God? He need to write a name of a man in his chair. A man, do you know what a man is? Guys, to just to make you like, you know, think about it. If you look at the earth, in this space, the whole earth is not even in the size of a dust compared to this universe, amazing, huge universe. So imagine the God who created all this huge, crazy universe. He wrote the name of Muhammad in his chair.
Yeah, but CP, you know, the thing is, it's not only that. You have many gods in Islam. We know that the Quran has 114 chapters. So you have 140 chapters that will be God. So you 140 plus Allah plus Muhammad. Then you have Umar, who abrogated Mut'a. So Umar is also Allah, because he can abrogate the Mut'a of Allah in the Quran. So how many gods we have now?
Well, I think our caller here is are you fasting Ramadan or something?
Me? No. Yeah? No? Okay. I forgot, man. I forgot.
My friend. The Muslims will say, when you say you they have 114 God in the Quran, you need to explain to them, because the Quran is not created, correct?
Yes.
So as long, guys, just to explain to you what he's saying, the Quran, according to Muslim, is not created. Okay. Allah is not created. Okay. So now we have two uncreated object or person, whatever you want to call them. As long the Quran is 114
God, right?
Chapters.
So Quran is also God.
It must be a divine, because it's uncreated. Yeah. Who is the one who created the Quran? The Muslims, they say it is uncreated. Okay, yes, so now exactly. Allah is uncreated, and Quran is not created. So now we have two uncreated individuals. How that can be? How you Muslims, you say to us Allah is one, and then we find that there is two uncreated, because if Allah is the creator, then anything after him should be created by him.
Yeah, but and what about Yameen Allah, the black stone of Allah?
Who is well, you know, 2 days ago, a Muslim, he called me and he got me busted. He said, this is weak.
It is weak? Yameen Allah is weak?
Yeah, everything is weak.
Yeah, but it will have a mouth and it will speak. So
no, Yameen Allah, the black stone, they say that it is a weak hadith. But the hadith about Allah have right hands is not weak. If you remember, Allah, he have two hands and both of them in the right side, which is very nice, actually. You know, imagine you are in the beach and there's like a, you know, like you are a single like me, and you have two hands in the right side and both of them in your pocket and walking in the beach. The women, they will go crazy, man. You have two hands in the right side and nothing in the left side. So according to Muhammad, Allah have two hands. And both hands of Allah are in his right side, as you see in the front of you on the screen.
But CP, if Allah has two right hands, wouldn't Allah be a really funny creature?
Actually, I think he's cute. Me, myself, I would like to take a selfie with him from the left side so I can spank him and he will not be able to beat me back. Because if you're two hands in the right side, how you can defend yourself from the left side?
But I think Allah would have a nice time. One shisha in the right hand, the other shisha in the other right hand, right? Imagine Allah smoking two shishas with one, if two right hands, man.
If I put the cell phone in the pocket of Allah in the left side, how Allah can get it? And why Allah have, I mean, what the problem with the Muslims that Allah hands both are in the right side? You see, the Muslims, because Islam is a counterfeit religion, they learn from the Old Testament and from the Bible that the word right, you see, the right side of God, it's the right, you know, so the word right have a religious meaning. But Muhammad, because he take it in a literate way, so his God became so funny. So now Allah have two hands and both of them they are right, because it's going to be a problem if Allah have a left hand. Because remember, Shaitan have left hands. Allah cannot have left hands. Shaitan, yeah. He eat, if you, when you eat by the left hand, Shaitan eat with you.
Man, to be honest, I think this Allah of Muslims really looks funny. Imagine he has two right hands. He is short, he's fat, and he has really curly hair, right?
Yeah.
So can you draw Allah for us, CP? I mean, you can do it, right?
Well,
I know you are. Yeah, really, actually, really good artist.
I won many prize before about drawing, as you know, and actually, you know, I'm sure you have some of my paint. Did you buy any of them?
maybe we can put it besides Mona Lisa in France.
Yeah. Well, if we go to the Hadith, we will find Muhammad describe how Allah looked like. And Muhammad, he was confused about how the Muslims, they will believe in the Antichrist. So here in the Hadith in front of us, it says that Allah, so, I don't know what does that mean, SAWWWW.com, S, said, I told you so much about the Dajjal, the Antichrist. Muslims, why you Muslims believe in the Antichrist? Why the Antichrist is Antichrist, not anti-Allah? Why he is not anti-Muhammad? Muhammad is the last prophet. Look like Muhammad is not the problem for the devil. Christ is the problem. Here we go. Even the Muslims believe is exposing Islam. How in the world you say to us, Jesus is just a prophet, but yet the devil is Antichrist?
Yeah.
Why in the world, if Allah, he sent 124,000 prophet, why the devil choose to be Antichrist, not anti-Muhammad, not anti-Abraham, not anti-David, not anti-anyone, especially Muhammad? Why Antichrist? They have no answer. Let it go. Then Muhammad, he says, I'm afraid that you may not understand. The Antichrist is short, hinted, blah, 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 and here we go, and eyesightless, neither protruding nor deep-seated. I mean, look at the description. And what Muhammad is worried about, he is worried that they will misbelieve in the wrong person. And now he confirmed that this description is exactly the description of Allah, except Allah is not one-eyed. So what the difference between the Antichrist and Allah is just one eye. The right eye is not damaged. Allah is a man. Yeah. You know,
I think Allah looks like a pirate, CP.
I don't know, really. You know,
if you remove,
I don't know if you
look like a pirate.
Yeah, if you look at the description, you look weird. Look like Charlie Chaplin somehow. You know, I don't know, but the important is why the Muslims even why Muhammad is worrying about the Muslim will be confused between Allah and the man. The man is a man, because the Dajjal, the Antichrist, he is a person, as you see, he will come as a man. And Muhammad described him as a man, he's a human being. So why the Muslims will think that he is Allah? And why the description is about physical shape? If this guy is the devil, I mean, can't he fix his eye? He can go to any clinic, you know? They can install a fake one, nobody will notice. Isn't it the Quran, and isn't it what the Muslims believe, that Shaitan, the genie, he came and he took the look of Suleiman? That's mean the Shaitan, and all the Muslims believe that Shaitan can change his
he's shapeshifter, right?
Yeah, he's shapeshifter and he can change his look. Even the Quran says, "You see him, but he sees you, but you don't see him." So this is why he's called genie. Actually, the word Jannah is coming from the jinn. What is the jinn? Jinn is something you cannot see. So the person who is able or capable of being unseen, and he can change, because how he can be unseen, because he changed his shape. He can be Muhammad. He says the black dog is a devil. So what, which mean the genie can take the shape of a black dog. The Muslim believe even genie can come to you as a human and have sex with you. The genie can come as a camel, can come as a cow, can come as a tree, can come as anything. So if this is a genie, and the Antichrist is the Dajjal, who is a shaitan, which means he's a genie, so what the point of saying he have a problem with the right eye?
Yeah, but also a genie can come also in a human shape, because in Islam a genie can have sex with a Muslim woman, right?
Yes.
Not only, so can't he give himself a second eye and look like Allah? I mean, the only difference is that Allah has more than one eye, right? So, I mean, if Shaitan can do anything, he can look like Allah. So what's the problem?
Muhammad, he met with some genie. He claimed that he met with some genie from Nasribin, which is an Assyrian, like territory at that time. And he claimed that those people are genie. Why? Because they are tall. And then he met another group. He claimed that they are genie because they are black. You know?
Yeah, and this Sabine, it's still a neighborhood in Syria. It still exists.
Yeah, I know. No, it exists. But yeah. I mean, this guy, he met with people, and he claimed that they are a genie, but they are in the shape of a human being.
Exactly. Another thing, you know about the story that two Jewish women came to Aisha and they basically played with her a game, right? And they trolled her about Azab al-Qabr, right?
Punishment of the grave.
But you know, when you look at the different thing, when Muslims love to give us Surah 2, verse 79, where it says that the Jews played with something, you know, they wrote scripture and they said this is from Allah. But if you go to Tafsir al-Jalalain, for example, they played the exact same game with Muhammad. You know, they wrote something, some book, and they said to him, hey, this is from Allah. Yeah? Exactly the same game. Those Jews, they're really something, you know, they are really trolling Jews.
Well, you know, the Jews in the time of Muhammad, obviously, they made Muhammad angry for sure, and they got him busted in many ways. However, you know, the stories about the Jews from the Islamic source, I believe most of it is fabricated. Remember, you know, this is a one-sided history, same as the Christians. Yeah. You know, you yourself, you came from the Middle East. If you watch in the month of Ramadan, and this is now we are in the Ramadan, they play series like movies about Islam and Jewish and Christians. Yeah. Always in the movie, they make the Jewish guy or the Christian guy is a guy who have a long nose, and he have a nose like a chicken, you know, like his like a witch, you know.
Yeah,
he's an ugly guy, disgusting. He have no honor. He like money. He drink wine, and his wife she sleep around. And there are people who spend the night just having sex and having drinking wine, and the Muslims are the people who is praying to God, spending their day praying, asking Allah for forgiveness, and their faces is like, you know, glorious people.
Yeah, but CP, you have one problem. If you go to the Hadith, you will see that in the early period of Islam, the men, they used to go around with their male parts dripping, right? You have it in the Hadith.
Yeah.
So how can they make that claim when in Ramadan, there is a place, you know, I think it's in Medina. I'm not sure if it is Mecca or Medina. I think it's in Medina. They go around and they have sex and they have dripping male parts. But if you go to the English translation, it's totally different, right? Maybe you can explain to the audience.
Yeah, actually. Here it says, imagine, like, guys, do you see it? This is the hadith he's talking about. Here they are doing tawaf, they are doing hajj, And exactly. They are, and during the Hajj, the guy is saying that we used to go around the Kaaba and our penises dripping semen. Do you see it, guys? Do you see it?
Yes.
We get out with our male organs dripping with semen. Now, why in the world those people, they are going to go around the Kaaba and their male organs dripping semen? Many Muslims,
because it was allowed. It was allowed.
Because they have sex around the Kaaba, because this is, it was a sexual religion, you know? It was a sexual religion. People, they go, and the different hadith mentioned that they used to go naked around the Kaaba, totally naked, you know? Otherwise, I mean, what do you mean your penis is dripping semen? Like, is it like the faucet is broken or something? I know. What's happening here?
Yeah, what a nasty, filthy, sick sex room.
Oh, please don't insult the prophet. Guys, I did not insult him. This is the caller. You know, I am not... Yeah. Disclaimer.
Sue me, guys. Sue me.
Yeah, I don't agree with you. That Muhammad, he wasn't a very just... You know, he's just an open-minded man. He's hippie.
Yeah, but didn't he used to clean his hands with the clothes of Aisha when they had sex? I mean, very clean, yeah.
No, he used to clean his hands in the floor, actually. But you see, the point of the prophet doing that, he is the best example for Jean-Claude Van Damme. You know him, this actor? They asked him in an interview in Emirat, how you can maintain yourself to be healthy like this and you are in this age? He said, look at the best example, as example, the prophet Muhammad. What a scam. This guy, he is doing a movie. Is paid by the Arab, by the Muslims in Emirat, so he know what they like to hear. You know, he's preparing himself. So he said, look, as an example, the best prophet. The prophet, he used to eat his boogers. The prophet, he used to drink the soup full of fleas, and the prophet used to be full of lice, and the prophet, he used to take a shower with dead dogs and women blood from period. And yet, the best example is the prophet.
Imagine. Yeah, and Salama loved to pick the lice from his hair, right?
Wasn't it Salama and Haram?
Oh,
yeah, man. many of them actually, yeah. But but remember,
must be a great hobby, right?
Yeah, but remember, at that time, actually, I don't know if you remember. Once I asked a Muslim in Nepal talk, he said, at that time, people don't kill the lice because it was the only entertainment they have.
Imagine how many Sahaba, because Muhammad had lice, they did it too, right? Because everything the Prophet did, they did the same.
Do you remember, Rob? Did you remember once when this guy, what his name, Osama Abdullah, he came to Pal Talk in my room, and he said to us, "You Christians are filthy, full of lice."
Yeah, and you showed them the hadith. Right?
Yeah, I said to him, "So are you saying the one who have lice is dirty?" He said, "Sure." Well, you know, do you know what lies happen? Why? I said, explain to us why. He said, because stupid, you stink and you didn't take a shower. And then I said to him,
you don't go easy on these guys.
Yeah. And then I said to him, so what do you say if I show you a prophet, he have lies? He started reading the hadith. He said, okay, I will be back.
Yeah,
in the other time he came to us, and we were talking about magic. He took the mic. He said, only stupid people believe in magic. I said, are you sure, Abdul? He said, yeah, I'm very sure. I said, so what do you say about the Quran speaking about Allah is the one who teach magic? He said, it's proven scientifically, it's false. What are you talking about? So I show him the verse, and then the Muslim, they made articles against him saying this guy is a kafir and he is denying that magic is coming from Allah.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. What we can say. Let us hope that some Muslims will call us. Do you have any more questions?
No, brother. It is a really pleasure to speak to you after such a long period. Keep it up. Guys, please support CP. God bless my friend, and maybe we'll talk again soon.
Thank you.
Quite any time, really
nice. Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.
See you, my friend.
Mommy, I want some milk. Oh, sure, Angel. Come here. Give me a little something. Slow down, honey. Your son is so cute. How old is he?
Oh, he's 48 months. That's four. Yeah.
Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling, yes. Yeah. I get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, no. Yeah. I just want to tell you right now that, I believe, I really do believe that something's got a hold on me here.
Oh, it must be love.
Oh, something's got a hold on me right now, child.
Oh, it must be love.
Let me tell you now, I've got a feeling, I feel so strange. Everything about me seems to have changed. Step by step, I got.
Later.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Yeah, I'm just curious.
You're very
regarding
curious, yeah.
Regarding this sucking the breast of adult for 10 times. Can you just tell me how many times when people come to your house, they suck the breast of your wife?
ورد في فتح المنعم في شرح صحيح في شرح صحيح مسلم لموسى شاهين لاشين الجزء الخامس صفحة 122 أنه قال أنه يدخل عليها الغلام الأيسع وكانت عائشة رضي الله عنها ترى أن أرضاع الكبير يحرم وأرضعت غلاما فعلا وكان يدخل عليها فهل كانت عائشة ترضع شباب قريش هل يجوز ذلك أن تعطيهم الحليب من صدرها؟
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله peace be upon everyone. Yesterday I left the
He
comment.
Wants to come to your house to experience.
Aisha would not disclose any matter which degrade the wife and the Prophet, peace upon him. And this is not the way of Islamic teaching because Islam is very protective to our women.
So let me
I didn't finish. Let me finish.
Finish quickly. I
know that you're always. Let me respond.
Okay, just get on.
Islam, if you know, sometimes when a male came to visit, we sit the male in one room and the female in another room. So it's not a way that we invite strange people to come and suck the breast of our women because we can suck them as well, our women. It's not a way that we invite strange people to come and suck the breast of our women because we can suck them as well, our women. It's our right to enjoy love. Up to you.
بلوك على الفيسبوك بلوك على الواتساب بلوك تليفونات بلوك انستغرام بلوك 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 عسل بلوك بلوك
I hope you all got that one. Yes, they do invite strangers to come and suck the breast of their wives. So, here's a couple of comments. If Yes, come. Oh, he wants our cameraman wants to come to your house to see suck the breast of females. that has no place in Christian scripture, brother. Don't make me to fire you.
So you just said exactly what I said is forbidden. If you come,
if you come
to my house and you look in a different way to my wife, I will remove your eyes.
It's
and you
good.
Will lose your life.
It
then.
Is good that you...
Do you, want to,
Yahya,
do you want me to execute
Yahya,
you?
This is not funny. It is not funny. Yes, you want to remove people's eyes if they come and then suck the breast of your wife. But who is going to stand for Aisha? Who is going to stand for the woman when Muhammad said, let this boy who has got the beards to suck the breast of her? Who is going to stand up for them? Muhammad didn't poke anyone's eyes. Muhammad didn't threaten anyone. Muhammad said, go and suck the breast of woman. So, you
I
said,
you, it's
I listened to you.
Our sunnah, it doesn't include breastfeed other people.
Of course, it is all lie.
All lie.
Sahih Muslim
you are the queen
was
of
lying. And Aisha, when she was testifying, she was lying. Remember, this is the Aisha who contributes to Sahih Bukhari with over 1,000 hadith. This is the Aisha, is the mother of believers. Yet, according to Muslims, she lies.
There is a hadith where the Prophet told a woman to suckle a man, and she said he is a grown man. And the Prophet replied, I know he is.
Ooh, ah, suck it to me like you want to. Ooh, I could take it like a pro, you know. Do a long throw with the backstroke. My hormones jumping like a disco. I be popping ish like some Crisco. And all you gotta say is miss it go. And when you say go, I won't move slow.
Suck it to me.
Ooh, I suck it to me like you want me to. Ooh, I can take it like a pro, you know. Do a long throw with the backstroke. My hormones jumping like a disco. I be popping mess like some Crisco. All you gotta say is miss it go. But when you say go, I won't move slow.
No.
To make it short, you know, because most of you do not know who is talking, this is one of the biggest imams of the Muslim Sunni. His name is a Sheikh Al-Albani, and he is explaining why we know we should practice that, and he's showing you the hadith as you see in the screen. You know, you can go and you can read the hadith, and you will see the story about the Prophet of Islam ordering women to give breastfeeding, you know, to an adult and a man. He is a stranger. A woman, she came to the Prophet, her name, Umm Hudayfa, you know, Sahla bint Suhail. And, you know, this is the name of the person, the woman. And she said to him, there is a guy, you know, I see like a dirty look in his face, which means he is looking to me in a sexual way, you know. So, you know, he said to her, the Prophet of Islam, you know, well, give him your breast. Okay. Oops. And let him suck it. Oops. And then, you know, suck it. So she said, how I can, you know, let suckle him as he is a grow up man. He is a growing up man. This is the Prophet of Islam. Give your breast to a stranger. The Messenger of Allah, he smiled. Ha, 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 ha. Let me do it in a different way. What this ha ha? This is better, right? Okay. Well, that's it. it's time for breastfeeding for you. Hello.
About adult breastfeeding. There are all kinds of fetishes and they're absolutely normal. You're going to have your own preferences. And the problem is that most people don't even know what their fetishes are or don't talk about them. So when you have a certain fetish, like a mother-son role play, and you think you're weird, it's because people are so ashamed of revealing their fantasies that you think you're the only one, but you are not.
Why your prophet kissed a black stone?
Okay, Jesus do more actually. Worse actually. Ah, he play with his mother boobs. Tell me why he's doing
he play with his mother what? Boobs? You must be okay. You see guys, you see how savage they are? Look what she said.
Oh no.
Look what she said.
Not,
look what she
not
said.
Like you.
Okay, show me a verse. Show me a verse.
Really?
Show me a verse saying that Jesus he played
why
with his mother boobs. Show me his a verse. Show me a verse saying that Jesus he played. Listen, you are obviously a trashy person. You just insulted Jesus for no reason. You said Jesus he played with his mother boobs, right? Okay, you're a liar, number one. Number two, it's your prophet who ordered women to give their boobs to strangers. Is that true or not?
No, it's not.
Can I suckle you? Okay, let us read the hadith. Can I suckle you? Can I suckle you? Listen. According to Islam, your boobs is lawful for me. Can I suckle you? Listen. As long as you are talking about boobs and you are a savage, low class person, why you're a prophet? Let us read together. Sahla bint Suhail. Let me mute you. You are so dumb. Listen, guys, look at this. Sahla bint Suhail came to the Messenger of Allah and said, I see a displeasure in the face of Abu Hudhaifa when Salim enters upon me. The Messenger, he said, breastfeed him. She said, how I can breastfeed him and he is a growing man. The prophet, he said, I know he is a growing man. So listen, Tahani, can you do breastfeeding for any friend of yours? When the last time you did the breastfeeding for an adult in your life? Be honest.
This is hadith.
What is guys? Did she say stupidity? Did she say that?
Where's this hadith? Tell me who said this.
Your prophet.
Where? Tell me this hadith.
In front of us. Here we go. It's in the screen, and it's a sahih hadith. Guys, does it say sahih? Sunan an-Nisa'i, hadith number 3320. It says sahih. Everybody can see it. You just admitted that this is a stupid hadith. Thank you very much. So you just admitted
yes,
that you're
because it's a weak.
What weak? It says sahih. Everybody
hadith,
can see everybody in the screen.
I have it in the screen.
Anything will make Islam look stupid. Right away they say it's not authentic.
Okay, so when you read the hadith and you do not like it, say that is the 1% which I'm talking about. And you read another hadith which you do not digest, you say the same.
It is not a true hadith that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam forget of any Quran.
What do you mean? Sahih al-Bukhari, a friend, Sahih al-Bukhari.
So are you having doubt concerning the hadith itself or concerning the narration or the chain of the narrators?
This is the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari.
Is not the true hadith.
My friend, it's Sahih Bukhari. How you can say
so,
that?
So in it was in Bukhari. We don't believe in this hadith.
Oh, under what authority you don't believe in hadith? If the hadith is say Sahih, even it's accepted by all the scholars of Islam. And here we go. You are a sheikh. Can you show me one scholar reject this hadith?
That Sahih al-Bukhari, all the Ummah agree that it is the most authentic book after the Quran.
Some Muslims have a doubt about Hadith. May Allah guide them.
Even though you are reading from their books, from what is approved by them for centuries, from what is written by their hands, collected by their hands, printed by their printing and by their ink, and they themselves, they are the one who paid the money to print those books, and to preserve them for centuries. So why today those books are not good no more?
There are hadiths mentioned in Bukhari and Muslim which contradict with Quran. So how can we expect that this hadith is sahih hadith?
But the Quran is not the only source of guidance for Muslims. We also need the sunnah and the living example of the Prophet Muhammad in order to fully comprehend and understand the religion of Islam.
You are a liar, you are a liar. It's in the front of me, it says sahih.
Really?
Look at the screen.
Tahani,
shut up. Big mouth like Aisha. It's in the front of me. It says a grade sahih. Sunan an-Nisa'i, hadith number 3320. In book reference, book number 26, hadith 125. Volume in English, volume 4, book number 26, hadith number 3322. And you said, and everybody heard you saying, that this is a stupid hadith. So you just admitted that your prophet is a stupid. I agree with you. What do you want to say? Go ahead.
I said this hadith is weak.
No, you said it's stupid. You said it's stupid.
You know that.
You said it's stupid.
Everybody, Muslims do this for.
Okay,
for
I will challenge you.
Time. If this hadith is right, you will find Muslims do this.
I'm sure you do it. I'm sure you do it. Prove it to me. You don't do it.
What?
That you don't do breastfeeding for adult. Do you have a proof?
Oh my God.
Baby, up.
He thought I was going to tell him I was pregnant.
Okay. Right. Almost corporate climber over here, pregnant.
What, you guys, I want to have a baby at some point. Maybe you can schedule one between a conference call and a client meeting. Okay, you know, Daryl is the one that I'm really worried about.
Oh, really?
Yeah, are you kidding me? You're lucky he wants one at all. I had to promise Greg I'd give him these. Okay, now. Okay, easy, fella. Ooh, this one's real grabby. Oh, he must have been breastfed. Is the baby hungry? Oh, he should be nursed.
Baby, light nursing.
Are you sure you should do that?
Oh, you don't have to be the birth mother to breastfeed.
Nope. Nursey.
You want a nursey.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, drink up, precious.
Ooh, this one's real wriggly, huh? Come on now. Suck it.
So now, go back to the basics. When man comes to your house, let's say, Muhammad Hijab come to your house, okay? And you are not at home. How many times, for how many minutes each time, needs to be for Muhammad Hijab to be able to sit down with your wife? How many times and how many minutes Muhammad Hijab needs to suck the breast of your wife?
Okay, let me respond. Then I come to Muhammad Hijab when I invite him to my house.
Ali!
Let me respond. Then I come to Muhammad Hijab when I invite him to my house and I'm not at home. When Bukhari came 185 years after the death of the Prophet and maybe Aisha. So it's obvious that this hadith is
all of them
very pleasing for you all to always them. Come up with, but
I am not pleased of it. I know it is very ugly. All I am saying is,
excuse me, how many times, Hatun boy,
when he comes to your house, boy, for how many seconds he needs to suck the breast of your wife?
Hatun. I didn't interrupt you, and I said, there's over 7,000 hadiths, and most of them are
in Sahih Bukhari.
Authentic, false, fabricated.
According to you, not according to Sahih Bukhari.
No, according to you.
Not according to early Muslim scholars, but according to 21st century Muslims.
According to you, is hadith authentic because you hate the Prophet, you hate Islam, you hate Quran, you hate Allah.
A
According to you, is hadith authentic? Because you hate the Prophet, you hate Islam, you hate Quran, you hate Allah. Regarding Muhammad Hijab, no one is welcome to my place if I am not there.
You're a liar. You're finished already.
Don't make assumption that somebody will come to my house and suck on the breast of anyone, because nobody is welcome if I'm not there.
Can you simply tell me just one sentence, okay? What is it wrong for man who has a beard to suck the breast of woman? What is wrong? Why do you think it's ugly and discredited? Like, what is wrong with it?
You want in one sentence without interrupting?
You can put two comma in that sentence.
With beard or without beard?
With beard.
He's not allowed to breastfeed on other people's women without authorization from Almighty God. And we, as Muslims, we are very protective of our women. And go and see your women who are going almost half naked. We are very close here, Winter Wonderland. And the Christian women are going even showing off most of their legs, most of their breasts, and they are going without any, almost half a nude.
And the funny, Muslims says that our women are so decent, we cover them, and the Prophet of Islam is ordering the women to give their breasts for a stranger. So why you are covering your wife or covering your women when you can give any man the opportunity to suck your women a breast?
Islam actually goes a step further. It's actually outside marriage. If you go to Sahih Bukhari, it says here, Sahih Bukhari, Ibn Abbas said that he gives the verdict that he asked about the muta marriage with women, and he permitted it. But muta is actually outside of marriage. You already have a wife. And here's also Muhammad allowing it. Sahih Bukhari, volume 7, 6252, it says here, Allah's messenger said, if a man or woman agrees on a temporary marriage, that's muta. The marriage should be last for 3 days.
That was more than one sentence, yet I have no answer to my basic question. But let me put it together. Allah, who is all wise and all merciful, uses Muhammad, and Muhammad tells people, if someone comes to your house, he needs to breast suck the woman. It was 10 times. Allah showed mercy and brought that to 5 times. And thanks to sheep, came and then eat the verse, which is not in the Quran today. So
you have the stamp from Allah
who gives you the permission. I am grateful today that you don't want your wife to go through that.
Yeah.
But I am disappointed, wife of your prophet, whom is the walking Quran, and wives are identified as the mother of believers, had to go through that. And I feel very sorry for Aisha.
Let me respond.
She had to go through that.
Let me respond.
But I am grateful.
Let me respond,
Allah,
please.
Used this sheep, which was very clever, that sheep came and then ate the right verse from the Quran.
Let me respond.
It never ended up in the Quran. That was my response.
The Quran states even after the Prophet death, his wife not allowed to marry somebody else. So how would
isn't
he?
Isn't that already disturbing? Isn't that already disturbing?
It is
Muhammad
disturbing
can have sex with as much as he wants.
You say, I give
and
you
he dies.
Something
his
contradicting.
Wives are not even able to marry
it
with someone else.
And do you have any other issue you want to?
I have lots of issues.
I'm here.
I have lots of issues, but you are not helping me with the
I'm
basic answer.
You know.
So if you don't want your wife to go through Muhammad hijab to suck the breast of your wife, let me give you another example. And then this time, just give me one sentence answer because I'm done, okay? So
you
if Muhammad hijab
asked me to give you one sentence,
if Muhammad hijab goes to the house of Ali Dawa,
darling Hatun,
and Ali Dawa is not at home, how many times Muhammad hijab needs to suck the breast of Ali Dawa's wife?
No, no, no,
no. No, no,
no, 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 no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no.
How many second or minute each sock needs to be?
And now you're doing backstabbing because the guy is not here to defend himself.
Oh, okay, I'm
and
sorry.
You are a very wicked woman.
So just so,
you are very
so
evil wicked woman.
They are not here to defend
why don't
themselves.
You talk about yourself?
I am asking
talk
basic
about
principle
me
of Islam.
Talk about me because
but
you're talking
Dawa
about somebody
gangs are not here to
and
defend themselves.
It's backstabbing, backbiting.
I am
and
asking
you have big mouth to backbite.
How many
you have
seconds?
Big mouth to backbite.
How many
and last
seconds?
Time I told you,
yeah,
your
yeah
tongue
how many
should
seconds
be circumcised. That means cut because you speak about other people in a bad way, and you should have respect for yourself because they are not here to decide
I don't
to defend
know
themselves.
I don't know why it is
I
backstepping. I don't know why.
You know, I love it.
Soon after you give quotation from the Islamic sources, that is expression of hate.
You know, I am
I don't
Muslim
know why.
I have
all
one
I am
wife
doing is I'm
you know
reading.
And I
there are
Brad
people
Brad
who are following
second
it.
Wait.
There are people
you know
who are following it. That's
you know
more
I have
dangerous.
Only one
yeah
wife.
I'll see you.
We are just asking very easy question. For God's sake, how Muslims can believe in such a garbage like this? What kind of a prophet? Listen carefully. What kind of prophet he will teach such a thing? The women, even the women, she is ashamed. She said, how? And this is showing you that this is no one at that time, nobody, none of those Arab ever did that before. Which showing that the Arab, they are not really bad people as Islam make them look like. Because if it is usual to be done, the women, she will say, okay, fine, you know. But as you see, she said, how? How I can? He's a growing man. This is a shame. But the evil man, he said, so what? And he is smiling as if it's nothing. As if it is nothing. Imagine yourself, you are the prophet of God, telling a woman, you know what? Give your breast to a stranger.
Do you understand this, my sister?
Muta muta.
No. Asake sake. Yeah.
Ooh, I suck it to me like you want to. Ooh, I could take it like a pro, you know. Do a long throw with the backstroke. My hormones jumping like a disco. I be popping ish like some Crisco. And all you gotta say is miss it go. And when you say go, I won't move slow.
Suck it to me.
Ooh, I suck it to me like you want me to. Ooh. I can take it like a pro, you know. Do a long throw with the backstroke. My hormones jumping like a disco. I be popping mess like some Crisco. All you gotta say is miss it go.